When creating a model in COMSOL Multiphysics, you will need to apply materials, physics boundary conditions, and other settings to the geometry. In this tutorial, we will show you how to easily see and select geometric entities that would otherwise be obstructed from view by other objects. This will be done through utilizing the hide-show geometry functionality available in the software. This is helpful for accessing hard-to-reach geometric entities, as well as for viewing results on just part of your model geometry. Here we have the bus bar box tutorial model opened up. And with this model, you can see we have several interior geometric entities contained inside the box, such as the bus bar and the bolts. We can choose to hide some of the geometric entities in this model so that it's easier to access the interior geometric entities. Let's say for now we wanted to hide this box domain. To do this quickly, we can utilize the hiding and showing geometric entities buttons in the graphics window toolbar. So first off, we would select the click and hide button. And then next, we want to specify the geometric entity level from which we'll be hiding entities. So since it's a box domain, we want to select domains. Now we can hover over the geometry we want to hide. You can see the box is highlighted in red. And we can just go ahead and click, and that geometry is now hidden from our view. Please remember that whenever you're done hiding the parts of the geometry you want to, be sure to deselect the click and hide button. If you ever mistakenly hide parts of the geometry that you didn't mean to, you can always use the reset hiding button to start over. Now I'm going to remove the block from the geometry sequence. To focus on hiding geometric entities just within the bus bar. Let's say we want to hide some of the boundaries of the bus bar so that we can see the top two bolt domains at the base of the bus bar. We can again go ahead and select the click and hide button. From there, we want to make sure we specify the geometric entity level, which would be boundaries, and then we can go ahead and choose the parts that we want to hide. So now we can see these top two bolt domains, and it makes it easier to see them and select them if we want to apply any model settings. And we can do this with every geometric entity level. So let's say we wanted to hide some edges, we could go ahead, I'll demonstrate hiding an edge. And if we want to hide points, we can do that as well. Once again, when we are finished hiding the entities that we want to, we deselect the click and hide button. Next to this are several other buttons which we can use to change the view of the geometry. The view unhidden button only displays geometric entities that are not hidden, which is what we currently see in the graphics window. The view hidden only button only displays the geometric entities that we chose to hide. You can also use the view all button to display all of the geometry in your model, whether hidden or not hidden. Please note that when you do hide geometric entities in your model, COMSOL Multiphysics automatically creates an explicit selection list of all the hidden entities. You can find this list under the definitions and view nodes. So here, the entities hidden are organized by geometric entity level. So we have our list for the points we chose to hide, a list for the edges, as well as the boundaries. This makes it easier to change the geometric entities hidden in your model by simply editing the list, as opposed to using the reset hiding button and having to start over. Additionally, you can customize what geometric entities are hidden depending on the model tree item you currently have open. The Hide for Geometry feature hides geometric entities from view in the geometry branch only. If you recall from earlier, when we were hiding geometric entities, we did so all within the geometry branch. As a result, we have several Hide for Geometry subnodes here. If we had hidden these same geometric entities in any of the physics nodes, for example, we would have utilized the Hide for Physics feature, and all of these nodes would be Hide for Physics nodes. The Hide for Physics feature hides geometric entities from view while working in the Materials, physics, mesh, study, or results branch. Likewise, the hide for mesh import feature hides geometric entities for an imported mesh geometry from our view while working in the materials, physics, mesh, study, and results nodes. As you can see, the software contains a variety of tools which you can use to see inside a complicated geometry. Additionally, you can edit the list of geometric entities you want hidden and even customize what entities are to be hidden in the geometry depending on the model tree item you currently have open in the Model Builder window. It is through these tools that we are able to visually remove layers of a geometry, and as a result, able to access the most hard-to-reach geometric entities, no matter how complicated the geometry.